is the Full Coast here, live and direct from Brooklyn in New York. And from me today, I have some cards I'd like to showcase. So to satisfy your quest, which I don't necessarily detest, in truth or in jest, I am going to showcase some 25 cards that hold some sentimental attachment to me. Note that these aren't the highest up high-end cards. I'm not very pretentious. I'm going to showcase mostly autos because that's what I focus on typically. Maybe a few game used, mostly ones I've hit, a few that I picked up. And you guys had requested me to showcase some of my cards. A lot of them you've probably seen in the background, but these are some of my favorite, and I'll explain why. And by the way, guys, I will be announcing my contest winner as part of the 2021 Leaf ITG game use break. I will break that product within the next week as soon as the box arrives. All right, guys, so let's get on to this 25 list. I'll just enumerate them from 1 to 25. They're in no particular order, but I thought I'd showcase some of my favorite cards. All right, number one. Number one would happen to be the Jean Béliveau Pencraft Pinnacle Donruss Auto. So in a low-end box of Pinnacle, I hit a number to 50 auto of Jean Béliveau. It's a bucket list type thing for me. One of the most consistent autos in the hobby, a lot like the Guy Lafleur. He does it diligently to sort of pay homage to every fan that they deserve his respect and time. And hitting this in like a $35 box for me was amazing. In fact, to give you an idea, equally tied for number one of this 25 list is this one of Freddie Anderson, which was equally in a box of titanium, similar sort of low to mid-end product. This is a sticker auto, but I've loved Freddie ever since he was with the Ducks. And just to be able to hit sort of some of my favorite, most sentimental players in low-end boxes for me is just makes it so worth it, and I really value these autos. All right, so officially number two would be this one, which I just hit the other day, 2014-15 Ultimate ITG Leaf. I hit this Patrick, it's considered a gold, and it's number to two only. Again, it's a sticker auto. I seem to love sticker autos because I find them accessible. It means you can still receive sticker autos from players who are deceased, like Gordie Howe. And this is a really cool slab card that I just recently got within a box. I'd always wanted to hit a Patrick, and I hit my Patrick. Number three, within a box of SB Authentic, I actually hit a bucket list card, a Gretzky Spezza Thornton, number to 25, Sign of the Times. Unfortunately, it was a redemption, expired redemption. So that was sort of a big deal for me to hit that. And this was their replacement card through their lottery, or through their raffle, if you will. And they replaced it with the Howe Iserman Zetterberg, which is a pretty decent replacement. I'm very, very proud to have hit that card, and I'm even, or just as elated, although I prefer the Gretzky myself. I love this replacement card that they gave me. So that would be number three. Number four, within a box of SPX, 2009-10, in fact, fishing for the John Tavares rookie card, I hit this case hit of Carey Price, number to 50. How happy was I to hit a Carey Price auto? Again, it's a sticker auto. I love SPX, even though it's sticker autos. I just think it's a beautiful card. And it's funny when you're fishing for the ideal, you know, rookie card, and then you receive something that sort of warrants just as much excitement. You know, it was just one of my most memorable hits, so I love this one. Number five, I'm going to show you guys a bunch of Connor McDavid's within this 25 list. Here is the Maple Leaf Forever. Now, this is unnumbered, but the Maple Leaf Forever from the Team Canada Juniors, this one's from 2015-16, is such a great series of die cuts. And I think I paid for this one, but I certainly paid like under $150 for it. It's a quasi rookie card, of course. Typically, they don't consider these true rookies, obviously, plus it's an insert. But this is one of my favorite Connor McDavid's because it's a very unique looking card from a series of Team Canada Juniors that I really enjoy. Number six would be another Connor McDavid. So this one is from Full Force 2015-16, which was a one-off product, really ugly, gaudy product. But for me, it was one of the most interesting master sets to try to complete. Really enjoy it. And this is one of the rarest cards, if not the rarest card in the entire set, because I believe these are a Group A 1 in 12,960. It's, as you can see, it is a PSA 9. And I prefer PSA to Beckett. I know everybody's going to say that Beckett's better. I just find them less pretentious. I find them a little bit less sort of trying to control our hobby and how we monetize our hobby. So I'm a big fan of PSA. I just love the way that they grade cards so simply and so on. And this is one of my favorite McDavid rookie cards. Number seven, another McDavid would happen to be the Canvas McDavid. So, you know, for example, the Young Guns, I believe, hit, they're like case hits, and these are every fourth or fifth case, typically the Young Gun Canvases are. So it's a rarer card than his true rookie. This is not a true rookie card because it's a lettered card. it's lettered C211, right? But I like this one better than the Young Guns. I just think it looks cooler. And you know, the price of this one versus the price of the normal Young Guns, probably similar because this one's rare and the other one's a true rookie card. Well, this one isn't. And it's a Gem Mint 10 PSA, which I love. Now, of course, I'll mention Matthews. Matthews I typically have in my pool. I think he's an absolute stud and a star. This year he's going off. And of course I have his Young Gun. So this is a simple Young Gun. What I like about this particular Young Gun, besides the fact that it looks posed a little bit like the Lafreniere and a little bit like the old Maurice Richard, is that I got this within a blaster box. So can you do any better than hitting one of the best Young Guns in the history of Young Guns in a blaster box? That's why this one holds so much sentimental value for me. Number nine is this one here. So I've been collecting the souvenirs and OPG materials forever. I certainly have a ton of them from 2008, 9, 9, 10, etc. This is one of the ugliest years, one of the most gaudy, sort of campy, weird looking years of this stuff. The reason why I like this one in particular, I'm showcasing it, is it's really hard to hit the Gretzky, Lemieux, Messier, and Iserman one. So this is really cool. It's a very campy looking card, very OPG. And because I collect these, it is one of my favorites. Number 10 is this Flower. So Flower is one of my favorite goalies all time, if not the favorite, alongside Plante and Dryden, etc. And he's fifth all time in wins. And someone threw this in. I bought another card and they threw this in. They coupled them together. And this is this cool Black Diamond Championship banner one with, again, a sticker auto. I'm not so discerning when it comes to those stickers, as you know. And then 24 of 25. And it's Flowers off to spectacular start this year. Everybody discounted him with Leonard, but of course, Marc-Andre Fleury is and will continue to be one of the best goalies in the history of our game. All right, number 11. So I recently purchased this one. So this is a Leaf Ultimate. I believe it's 2019-20, unless I'm mistaken. And it's an eight-way auto. So you can buy the cup, and if you're lucky, you'll hit an eight-way auto, and it's gonna be worth $200, $500, $700. What I love about Leaf is they are so affordable. So we have Hasek, Cheevers, Grant Fuhr, Glenn Hall, and we have Billy Smith, Rogie Vachon, Felix Podvin, and Curtis Joseph. So these are all goalies from within my lifetime that I really appreciate and enjoyed. And it's number 24. It's one of the coolest multi-autos I've ever owned. And I didn't have to break the bank for it. And that's why I love it. Unlike the cup and so on, you can purchase an auto like this for like $70 online. I think that's sweet. All right, number 12, another Austin Matthews. So this was the first rookie card I've gotten of his. It was a Shadowbox rookie patch auto. What I love about it, it has the stems of the Leaf. It's a pretty nice looking auto, number 299. And look how thick this card is. I know some people find these cards really ugly, but it just is one of my favorites. I just love the depth and the sort of the bulk of it. So there you go. Number 13 would happen to be this one. Of course, I hit this within Allure last year. I was out in LA, I was out on the deck, and I completely freaked out when I hit this. I was opening up a box of the Allure, contrasting it to a box of Contours. I hit the Leon in the Contours, and I hit this one in the Allure. And what's so amazing about it, it's not just an Allure Quartz auto, it's a Quartz Blue auto, number 5. Probably my luckiest McDavid hit. Number 14 is this Maurice Richard auto. So in 1994-95, I believe, Parker's created a series of cards that look just like the cards that would have existed, I think, in around 56. There was a skipping, I think Parker's existed in 55. They skipped a year right around that time. So there was a missing link, and they called these cards a missing link because they produced cards that would have existed had they printed cards that year. And Maurice Richard was a friend of my grandfather's. In fact, my mom had her first television from in the ghetto in Montreal because she begged her dad to get a TV so she could watch Maurice Richard, which she in fact did, and later he became a friend of his later on in life. Number 15 is this one. So this Connor McDavid auto from Champs 2015-16. There is, by the way, a short print where he's facing right, which is a really cool card to get if you can master that. But I hit this in one of my first breaks. It was probably one of my worst breaks because I didn't have my glasses on. I couldn't even tell that I'd hit the redemption for the McDavid auto, the ideal card. And then I was kind of like taken aback when I realized what I'd hit. Of course, they sent this in. I haven't removed it from the initial sleeve that they put it in. Number 16. So number 16 is from one of my favorite series in all the hobbies, the 2018 Habs Bleu Blanc Rouge from President's Choice. President's Choice is done by Dr. Price, who also did ITG. They're some of the most beautiful cards. They don't own the rights, which I love, so they have to get creative about logos and stuff. But this is the Ken Dryden, super rare card, numbered only to 5. I love this card. Number 17, another Connor McDavid. Now, the reason why I showcase this one is it was released before, Black Diamond was released before all the other rookie cards for the most part. So it was the first auto jersey card that I was able to get during the whole frenzy to hit McDavid's. So it's numbered to 125. It's called the Rookie Diamond Signature Materials. They have placards. They also have black placards with silver ink. They're very similar cards. But this was before all the other rookie cards were released. I was able to get my hands on this one. Obviously, it's gone up in value. Number 18, I just recently hit this. This is a Platinum 1/1. And what's amazing about it, I hit in 2014-15 Ultimate by Leaf. And it is a Jacques Plante, Ed Jacobin, and Gump Worsley, Bleu Blanc Rouge. Of course, he's with the Rangers, Jacobin. But being a New Yorker, being a Montrealer, these filthy, literally filthy patches. One of the best cards I've ever hit. I love this card. Number 19, you've probably seen this card in the background. So this 2007-08 Carey Price rookie card is numbered only to 13. So it is the Gold Spectrum Parallel, Patch Parallel. Obviously, you've seen these cards online. You've certainly seen the number to, what is it, to 299. You might have seen the Gold's number to 50. But what's so rare about this is that it's numbered only to 15. The only lower numbered card from Obituary Premier from 2007-08 of a Carey Price would be the 1/1 black. So I'm so happy to have one of these. There's only 14 other ones in existence. Obviously, I'm a huge Carey Price fan, along with the rest of my Habs goaltenders in history. Number 20. Number 20 is a Crosby rookie card, married to Gretzky. Of course, it's an insert winning combos from SPX. SPX, one of my favorite products. It's graded 9. I actually had the raw card and I poured coffee on it, if you can believe that. So I had to replace it. I still have the one with coffee. It actually doesn't look that bad. But can you imagine my pouring coffee on one of my favorite cards in history? There's a better card that's a duel with the autos. Of course, that one's really, really hard to hit and probably worth thousands at this point. This one, not so much, but I love it because it's so accessible and affordable, and I love the idea that it's a Crosby rookie card with Gretzky. 21 is a tie between these two superlative slash ultimate Leaf products from last year. So I hit this unbelievable Jacques Plante, which is the jersey stick. I'm not really sure. And it's number to 15. This isn't even a parallel, but of course, he's historically, my avatar, is one of my favorite goalies in the history of the game. Also, around the same time, I hit this one here, which was this Trouvaille. I believe this is superlative, and it's a Leaf product, 3/3, number 3/3, and it's a Jean Béliveau and a Maurice Richard. This is Jean Béliveau's glove, if you can imagine that. Of all the ones to hit within a superlative box, I happen to hit a Maurice Richard Jean Béliveau, which is awesome. Number 22. So I mentioned that I'm not very pretentious. Well, here is case in point. Look at this Bobby Orr rookie card, graded by KSA, not the most reputable grader in comparison and contrast to some of the others. It's a graded 1. It has like tape residue on two sides. It's missing chunks. I just love this card. And you know it's past hands. You know that it's been transferred from person to person. You know it's authentic because no one would create a rookie card this battered. It does have the little bubble on the line, which is sort of the indication of authenticity for some of these old cards. It's crooked. Back looks actually pretty decent. I think I paid about $200 for it when I bought it, but I absolutely love it. It's just one of my favorite cards because it's the real deal Holyfield. I mean, you can't deny it. Number 23, like I mentioned, President's Choice from 2018, I believe it was, the Habs Bleu Blanc Rouge one, is one of my favorite sets in the entire hobby. And this is unbelievable. I have a Haynesworth, Blake, Dernan, and Bouchard. I mean, Haynesworth, I think, died in 1950, to give you an idea. And it's a jersey with all three colors. This is a skate. This is a glove. I mean, this is a stick. So cool. This is one of my favorite cards all time. Number to 5 only. And just to give you an idea, I have a couple of cards from that series, including this 1930s one, which again has Haynesworth, but has Joliet, has Howie Morenz, and has Blake. So these are my favorite cards all time, I think. I just love these cards. Those two would be tied for 23, I'd say. 24 is this buyback. I think it's a 2012-13 buyback of OPG, but it's a buyback, auto buyback of Sidney Crosby. Of course, you recognize the card from John Tavares' rookie year, the 2009-10 OPC, and it was a buyback that they inserted in 2012-13, number just 20 only. I mean, can you do any better than a Crosby buyback? And of course, it's Beckett 10 Auto. I love it. Just too cool for school. And there you have a little emblem on the back. All right, guys, 25. You might have seen this one in the background recently. It's from the same series, The President's Choice, Bleu Blanc Rouge, and it is the Dick Irving Sr. So this guy played in the teens, he played in the 20s, he was one of the best hockey players of his era, but he's also one of the best coaches. I think he's a four-time Stanley Cup coach, and he coached Chicago, he coached Toronto, and he also coached the Habs, obviously. So this is a paper cut auto, and it is the 101. I always wanted his auto. I wanted one of Turk Broda. There's a couple of players like George Hainsworth and so on that I've wanted cut autos, but Dick Irving to me is one of my favorite cards. I can't believe it. It's just this little sort of penciled auto, and just shows, again, I'm not pretentious about it. It's more just the sentimental attachment to the history of our franchise and our hobby and Les Glorieux. And he played for Winnipeg and Regina, by the way, as well. So there you go, guys. That's it. That's my top 25 of ones that were easily accessible to me, by the way. I have a bunch of other ones that I could have drawn from, but they're just ones that were top of mind that I have in my little locker here. I also have crates in Montreal. I have a closet full of stuff, but these were ones I could yank really easily and give you a bit of a storyline around. This is not a hockey card. It's a book, obviously, but this was in the locker. I thought I'd showcase this, Prayer and El Islam. Now, guys, this is not a political thread, and it's not an ideological thread, and it's not a religious thread. And I know someone gave me grief the other day because I said praise Buddha as opposed to praise Jesus. Who cares, guys? This is about hockey cards. But I mention this book because it has Muhammad Ali's autograph in it, and it's authentic. I know it's authentic because I know the books from the era. I know when he signed and so on. And it's actually one of my prized possessions just because Muhammad Ali was a hero of mine when I was a kid, and he did fight for his own belief system, which is something I really admire. And of course, he was cherished later in life. But how cool is that? I have a bunch of other things like a Subban jersey that Subban sent my mom on her deathbed. I have a Bobby Orr signed book. I have stuff like that. But this one in particular, I thought is interesting because you just don't see these things. Of course, you might be able to see it online somewhere. So that's basically it, guys. I will break the 2020-21 ITG game used. I will announce my winner within that one. Please be sure to sub, like, hashtag Dryden, ring the bell. I have a new full cards live and direct from a place called Brooklyn, New York. You fucked me.